President, I have the rare privilege, of offering an award. An award to a man who, when I arrived in your country 3 years ago, had no food enough. To him and his wife, and me and mine, two Israeli women. And he sort of took me under his wing and sort of tried to explain to me what goes on here in the United Kingdom. This man is a member of the House of Lords. This man was for a number of years the president of the Royal College of Physicians. This man is a strident supporter of Zionism and an enemy of every anti-Semite. This man has written an excellent book about the Balfour Declaration and about Britain's contribution to the creation of the State of Israel. And this is a man who gladly supports so many, many good causes. Unfortunately, his son, Daniel, was killed at the age of 37 in a plane crash. And the Lord Lady Turnbow established a fund, the Daniel Turnbow Memorial Fund, which is supporting so many good causes. Lord Turnbow, I know that when I go to the House of Lords, you're always there to give me counsel, to give me advice. I know whenever there's a debate, and some of your fellow peers will stand up and say the most atrocious and untrue things about Israel, that you are there, together with some of your colleagues, standing up, just as the stand with us people do on university campuses, you are there in the Lords, a friend of Israel, fighting anti-Semitism, fighting anti-Zionism, and for that I thank you. And it is a pleasure. It is a pleasure, on behalf of Stand With Us, to present to you tonight the Beacon of Light Award. And you truly are a beacon of light.
Again, anti-Semitism and anti-Zionism are rearing their nasty heads everywhere, it seems, in America, in Europe, in our own dear England, where for so long we felt perfectly safe. After the last war and the Holocaust, anti-Semitism went out of fashion. And the new state of Israel was greeted by many with a lot of favor, who can't remember, for example, the impact of that remarkable Israeli success at the release of the hostages at Entebbe, when Jews in the United Kingdom could walk around proudly wearing their kippot. But as Richard Crossman has said, anti-Semitism is a light sleeper, and now we are once again thrown on the defensive. And we Jews are being forced to examine what it is we are and what we stand for. Ilan has given us some idea of what the Jews are and what we do very nicely, very humorously. I'm not going to take that line. It is, or is it, just a common social culture that we have, that we share? Or is there something more? Is it our religion that holds us together? Or are we a race? Nation? Those are questions that have been around a very long time and everyone's trying to answer them, but now we do need to answer them. Paradoxically, it is the rise of anti-Semitism that has made us recognize that we are rather more than the like-minded cultural beings we seem to be. And when anti-Semites hide their anti-Semitism behind an anti-Israel and an anti-Zionist position, we should know that maybe they are right, because being a Jew now is being part of the nation of Israel. We are all Israelis now. The anti-Semites certainly recognize that, and so should we. No speech now, of course, can avoid the Labour Party, our beloved Labour Party, and its brave leader, Jeremy C. I can't bring myself to utter the full name. And the prospect of a Labour government is making some Jews wonder if this is a country that we can remain comfortable in. And some even compare what's going on here with what went on in Nazi Germany in the 1930s. How could then such a civilised country, in which they were so well integrated, behaving the way that they did? Jews then thought that if they kept their heads down, it would all go away. So couldn't it just happen here? Well, I don't go along with that, because we are not keeping our heads down. Of course, it's worrying. And of course, we have to take it seriously. But we are fighting back. There were no Jewish demonstrations outside the Reichstag in 1933, as there were outside Parliament last year. There was no possibility of an official investigation into the anti-Semitism pervading the political party in Germany, as there is now by the Equality and Human Rights Commission into the Labour Party. And of course, there is this huge difference of having behind us an Israel that shows what can be achieved when you fight for what you know is right and just, as the ambassador said. So we can now wear our common history, heritage, and culture with pride, and keep our self-respect by Jews by fighting and not keeping our heads down. And we have our state of Israel. Yes, it is our state. And that brings me, of course, to our wonderful Stand With Us students. They are on the front line, on our campuses and in our schools. They certainly don't keep their heads down, and neither should we. And when I look with enormous respect at all that they managed to achieve, I'm even more encouraged to stand up for Israel here in England. I'm not being driven out. I'm not going anywhere. So while I thank you for this honour, I'm well aware that it really belongs to our students. Thank you very much.